are, that you know that the Lord God, he is with you all the way in the midst of your press. So he says, be strong and be courageous. And then he tells him even the more, but you got to be careful to obey all the instructions and medals that Moses gave to you. That there is going to be a word of instruction that is given unto you by Moses. And that when these instructions come down to you, you need to hearken your heart and your mind. You need to get your mind fixed, your heart fixed, so that you can move, so that you can do that which God is calling you to do in this hour. But oftentimes, when the word of God comes forth, it depends on who is speaking the word and not knowing, because we are not spiritually discerning that God is speaking to us, because it's not coming from a voice that we like to hear from. But God wants you to know today that when the Spirit of the Lord God began to speak, if you come out, if you came out of darkness, if you come out of that bad situation, know that you know that you know that when the Spirit of the living God begins to speak to us, we need to come out and go forth and do that which the Lord has said for us to do right now in this hour.
Come on,
the Spirit of the living God said, you've been in that place long enough. You have been blessed by the best to be a blessing in the kingdom of the Almighty God. You talked about your lack long enough. You've talked about your sickness long enough. You talked about your problems long enough. I hear the Spirit of the living God saying, you've been in that place long enough. It's time to rise and shine and give God your best praise. It's time to get up, get out, move forward, and do the work of he that sent you while it is your day, because night is on the way. I hear the Spirit of the living God saying, shake yourself loose, shake yourself loose, shake yourself out of debt, shake yourself out of problems and situations. For the Lord God saying, I done gave unto you everything that the locusts, palmworms, cankerworms, caterpillars, everything that ever ate up, chewed on your stuff, that this is your now moment. This is the right now time for you to possess the promises that God gave to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Well,
the blood of Jesus, you were grafted in. You deserve your possessions. Go in and get that which God has for you.
All right, all right.
And then he goes on to say, do not deviate from them, turning either to the right or to the left.
Oh God.
Don't deviate from the plans of God. If the Lord God brought it to you, he's going to allow you to go through it to get it.
Come on, Apostle.
We
hear you.
Oftentimes, we feel because we're going through it, we're not going to get it. But the Lord God said, early on Friday morning, as we were praying on the prayer line, God said unto us, it is already done. You've been in this place long enough. Know that you know that you know that you know that you know.
Come on, come on, come on.
Already done.
Come on, Apostle.
For it's already done.
Already done.
It's already done. Get up out of that place that you've been in long enough. Don't wait on nobody to do it for you. You have the ability, which is supernaturally in the spirit of the living God, to begin to prophesy over your situation and begin to speak to it. I've been here long enough. I know that God, I know that God, I know that God has already done it. So I'm going to receive what God has already done.
That's good.
Then he said, don't deviate from what I'm saying to you today as I give forth this prophetic utterance unto you. If you hearken your ears to hear what the Spirit of the living God is saying in the midst of your circumstance right now, right where you are, and don't deviate from hearing what the Spirit of the living God is saying to you right now. This is personal. But the Lord God, he's looking down at us, and he's seeing a people that he has already blessed, a people that he has already fulfilled every promise and every plan, and he's told us it's already done. So stop going back into that place. Where the enemy wants to captivate you and keep you from walking into the land in which he has given unto you. And I hear the Spirit of the living God saying to us here in this setting right now that you are landowners. I hear the Lord God says that you are a city within a city. You are entrepreneurs. You are those who build up the kingdom of the living God. I hear the Spirit of the living God say that you are a royal diadem in his hands, and no enemy can pluck you out. You are not left behind. I already have pushed you into a forward position. If you would just begin to move forward and know that even if you don't see the resources, I am your source. I am your resource. I have more than enough to pour into the hearts and the minds of the believer. I want you to stretch, stretch, even as you're working out to run a relay, to run a marathon. I want you to get your mind, your spirit in physical condition to receive everything that I have for you. I need you to take the limits off of me. You box me in far too long. I want you to release me from the box in which you have me in, because I am an exceedingly great God, and I'm doing an exceedingly great work. I've already executed my plan and my purpose in your life. You're not too young. You're not too old. Reach up. Grab it. Know that I am your God. I change not. I release my promises to Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. And today, this day, I am releasing to you a promise of living the life in the overflow. I am releasing to you an overwhelming amount of resources. People will connect to you. They will cause the fire of my spirit to begin to radiate, and they cannot release themselves from the drawing of my anointing. I'm drawing those with like passions, like minds that were channeled together by the Spirit of the Holy Ghost, and the oil of joy will be released in places of sorrow. You will see yourself crying no more. You will see yourself rising up in the ability supernaturally. No more pain, no more fear, no more agony, no more stress, no more pain, because I, the Lord God, have established you to do great exploits, to prove to the dying world that I am the King of all kings. I reign in my glory, and my glory shall be revealed through you as you yield yourself over to me.
Yes, Lord.
So, as we know that God has already done. Mm-hmm. Everything that he promised to us that he will do, that it is finished. That is finished. In the book of Joshua, verses 1 through 6, he tell Joshua, as Joshua was trying to get a people to move over into their place of promise, he says to them, be strong and be courageous. Yes. Be careful to obey the instructions Moses gave to you. Do not deviate from them, turning either to the right or to the left. Yes. If you don't do that, then you will be successful in everything you do. Study this book of instructions, the Word of God, continuously. Meditate on it day and night, so that you will be sure to obey everything that is written in it. Only then will you prosper and succeed in all that you do. Somebody say, word up. We got to be in the Word. We got to stay in the Word, because if we're in the Word, we won't find ourselves deviating from the plan of success. We will be able to accomplish everything that the Lord has set before us. But oftentimes, the reason that the blessings that the Lord have for us do not come into full fruition is because we deviate from the plan, the Word of God. And then he says that you don't need to get in a place of being afraid and discouraged. Yes. When Jayla gave her testimony, she said that God was working faith in me. Mm. He was trying to see whether or not if I prayed a word that he will fulfill that which I prayed. But sometimes we give out of patience and we feel that God has left us, and so we stay in a place of fear and discouragement too long. But today God said it's time to get up out of that place, because the enemy is the one who comes and brings discouragement and brings doubt and fear and unbelief. If you are battling with those things this morning, it is not of God. God does not make you fearful. He does not make you doubtful. He does not bring forth discouragement. All of those are spirits of the enemy. God says, go to the hill of the Amorites. Go there where those spirits live. And I want you to stand on the high places. And I want you to put those spirits, those imps, those enemies up under your feet and let them know that God has elevated you over that. You are no longer conquered. You are no longer bound by those spirits. You are no longer bound by those thoughts. You have come out. You might have been hurt in your past. Somebody may have done you wrong. You may have been abused, misused, talked about, hated. But you are no longer in those places anymore. God has elevated you. You've come out this morning. You are not the same as when you came in this morning. Your whole mind, attitude, disposition has been changed, because the Lord God said, you've been in that place long enough.
Long enough. Long enough.
We can talk about what folks have done to us. We can talk about who held us back. We can talk about who didn't stand with us when we needed someone to stand with us. But God says that I am with you always. We don't feel that we are not successful because we don't have the right folks standing with us. If God is standing with you, then that is enough. He says in Deuteronomy 1 and 8, he said, look, which is an action word. I need you to look. I need you to see with your father's eyes. Because oftentimes we are looking at things in the natural, and we're not looking at things with our father's eyes. But if we look with our father's eyes, we can see everything that the Lord has given unto us. I don't know about you, but I see the houses, and I see the lands, and I see the automobiles, and I see the businesses. I see all that the Lord God has promised unto because he gave us his word. And all I need is God's validation. And if I have God's validation, then that's enough for me. God had me to look back over things that I've written down over 10 years ago. Uh-huh. And when I began to look over the list of things that I was believing God for, things that I had hope in my heart for, things that I had faith enough to believe, I began to check off that list and say, it's already done. I don't know about you, but some of you need to go right now in the theater of your mind and begin to think about those things that you asked God for, and you need to begin to put a check mark there. It's all ready. Done. I was in that place long enough, but it's already done. God has already did that for me. I don't know about you, but I don't even have enough time to begin to tell you about how good God is. He's good, not just some of the time, but he's good all the time. The Lord God, he's increasing us on every side. I don't know about you, but I'm walking the land, and every place my feet trod upon, I'm saying, God, I thank you for this piece of ground. I thank you for your anointing, God, to do a great and powerful thing in this place.
Glory to God.
He said, I want to give to you. Look, I'm giving you all. I can just see the Lord speaking to Moses, and Moses there with his ears attentive to what the Spirit of the living God is saying. Because oftentimes when God begins to speak to us, if we're not by ourselves, and even if we're by ourselves sometimes, we are so easily distracted. And I pray that the saints of the Most High God, that we stop being so easily distracted when God is speaking. I mean, the God that made the heavens and the earth, he's speaking to us, and we are so easily distracted that we take our mind off of what he has shown us and what he is saying to us, and we begin to think about those things that our flesh, our soul brings up to us. But I pray in the name of Jesus that we bring everything, our emotions, our intellect, our will, under the Spirit of the Most High God, so that when the Spirit of the living God begins to speak, our intellect, our will, our soul, our mind line up with the Spirit of the living God, so that we can see the Spirit of the living God having his way in everything that concerns us. God is a spirit. And he says unto us, those that worship the Lord God must begin to worship him in the spirit, in truth, in the revelation, knowledge and understanding, that the only way I'm going to possess the land, that my spirit got to line up with the Spirit of the living God, where he can draw me into that place that he says only those that worship him in spirit and truth, only those that have a pure heart can see God begin to give every resource over unto them.
Glory to God.
But he said, I'm trying to give some stuff to you, and I need you to open up your eyes so that you can see it. And when you begin to see it, I need you to go in and occupy it. Go in and take residence there.
Take it.
God, you said that you are giving me this. I have a right to go in and occupy this space. Oh, God. So, what does he want us to occupy? What is it that he has given unto us? Because some of us cannot wrap our minds around it, because all we can think about is natural land. But land is just that place of space in which he was given the people to reside. But when they resided in that space, that there was resources coming down to them, because he said that when you get into the land, when you go into the place, in the place in which I have told you to occupy, I'm going to pour out unto you everything that you need need, because I want you to come out of a place of limitation where you limit me and say that I can't believe nor can I comprehend what God wants to give over to me. He told me to release today these things, and if you can just occupy the space, if you can just get in the place in your mind where you are this morning, that I'm getting ready to do some things. He said, first, I want you to know that when you come out and you occupy the land, when you stand in faith in the place where I have drawn you to, in the place of the milk and the honey, that means the resources, I'm about to do something in your finances. I'm about to give you an overflow in your finances. I don't know about you, but I need an overflow in my finances. I need some things paid off. I need some things turned around. He said, then I'm going to do some things in your physical health. If you would just stand in this land, in this place that I have pulled you into, I'm about to heal some bodies. I'm about to cure some diseases. I'm about to cause your natural body to line up. I hear the Spirit of a living God saying unto us right now, if there's anything going wrong with your body this morning, I want you to stand, occupy the space, come out from that place of sickness, that place of disease, because I'm about to release in this house, as you move out and move forward, my healing anointing is about to overtake you. You're about to see my signs, my miracles, and my wonders. The enemy has suffered in your body long enough. It's time for every enemy of sickness and diseases to come out, and it's time for you to move forward as you feel the fire, the power of the Holy Ghost upon you. You better begin to move forward. Say, enemy, I have come out this morning. Whatever your illness is, whatever it is that is trying to stand in the way of your breakthrough, you need to begin to press. I'm pressing in. I'm pressing in. I'm asking the Lord God that as we move by the Spirit of the living God, backaches, joints, loose the people now. They've been in that place of hurt in their physical bodies long enough. In the name of Jesus, I speak to arthritis. In the name of Jesus, loose, loose, loose. In the name of Jesus, run the out of my sickness. I pray in the name of Jesus that the fire of your healing anointing, you said, Lord God, you will feed us in this land, in this place, with milk and honey, God. I pray right now that the calcium that is needed in our bones, in the name of Jesus, strengthen us now by the milk that can only come from the throne room of God. In the name of Jesus, I pray right now that the bitter taste of pain that has so wrecked our bodies, loose now so that we can taste and enjoy the honey, the feeling good in every entity of our body. In the name of Jesus, God, I pray right now, oh my God, that you begin, Lord God, to shake loose in the name of Jesus every toxic waste. In the name of Jesus,